about every day. They hear me in the room hollering and saying, God, you've been good to me. Woke up this morning, started me on my way. Whoa, I wish there was some sense of it. He didn't have to do it.
Boys have to catch their breath when they walk from the car, so I feel bad. Come on and clap your hands one more time for the presence of Jesus Christ. Well, I don't have much. Bishop asked us to talk about these angels, the angelic hosts, these angelic beings that showed up in the scripture. Luke, the second chapter. Am I in the sanctified house tonight? We're not Baptists. We're not Methodists. We are sanctified folks. This is a talk back to me, Church of God in Christ. Holler back, preach, preacher. This is the kind of church that we have, and we will not change the culture of our church. Come on, somebody. No matter how dressed up we are, we will snatch a hat off and give God praise, no matter what. Anybody glad to be a saint?
Yes.
Luke, the second chapter says, and the angel said unto thee, fear not, for behold, I bring good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. He shall be a sign unto you, and ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. Watch this. And suddenly there was with the angels a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God, saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. 10th verse says, and the angel said, fear not, because I bring you good tidings. If you translate the word good tidings, it simply means good news. How many people believe that this is a season of good news for you? We live in a cell phone age where it seems as if every time the phone rings, if it ain't one thing, it's another. So many times we're hesitant to even face tomorrow because Satan will hold fear over our heads, making us believe that every time we get news, it's going to be bad news. And I was in Jerusalem and I went to Israel. We went to Capernaum. We went to the Sea of Galilee. And I was able to travel all over Jerusalem. One place I wanted to go went to Calvary, but I wanted to go to Bethlehem. It was the most dangerous place there. And they told us there's one place we cannot take you, and that is Bethlehem. It's too dangerous, and we don't want any of you to get hurt, and we don't want to be responsible. And I thought, how in the world is Bethlehem the most dangerous place, being that it was the place where it all started? It's the place where Jesus was born, wrapped in swaddling clothes. I thought Bethlehem would be the most sacred place. But now it is the most dangerous place. Then I thought about the scripture preached, Pastor Randolph. I thought about the fact that when you're down to nothing, you end up kind of at the bottom. Y'all don't know anything about that. But I believe Mary, when they could not find any place to go, they ended up in a place they really did not want to be. While they were there, they needed protection. And I just want to borrow for a moment that God never leaves us unprotected. God never leaves us without somebody watching over us. He never leaves us without the power of the blood up over your head. I'm gonna find my church. He never leaves you when you are all by yourself. He even promised that I'll never leave you, Lord, when I forsake you. There's a few of us in here that know when it felt like we were all by ourselves, he stepped in the midnight hour and said, I'll hold you and I am your comforter and I'll be with you to the end of the earth. I know that sometimes it feels like we are all alone, but can I tell you today, God is with you. So because you push beyond your tiredness and push beyond your worship, you understand that I made it to a place where God's going to give me something new. Grab your neighbor real quick and tell him good news, good news. After we come with good news, the good news is Jesus is here. Salvation is here. Healing just showed up. Blessings just stepped in the room. Miracles just came on the scene. What is the good news? The good news is, for unto us a child is born. For unto us a son is given. And his name shall be called Full of Wonder. His name shall be called Counselor. He will have power because he's the mighty God. He is the everlasting Father. And he is the Prince of Peace. And anybody that knows that's good news, well, tell somebody that's good news. And the Bible says, as I take my seat, after they gave the good news, the scripture said that the heavenly host showed up on the scene. I don't know who it was. It might have been Gabriel, and it might have been Michael. It might have been the heavenly host or the angels that showed up. But the Bible said that something happened in the atmosphere. Real quick, grab your neighbor, say, neighbor, something's about to happen in the atmosphere. What happened, Pastor Randolph? They began to sing praises to God. They began to open up their mouth and give God some praise. I come to tell you, when we give God praise, something happens in the atmosphere. Miracles happen in the atmosphere. Something's gonna happen in the atmosphere. They came down on the sea. 2017. Anybody feel like the enemy been holding on to some of your stuff? Don't lie to me. Trying to hold on to your mind. Trying to hold on to your children. You won't let your granddaughter go. Won't let your grandson go. Do I have a witness? The Bible says that at that name, every knee shall bow. It says that demons tremble.
All right.
I wish y'all stayed with me. At the name of Jesus. When I read that, I said, God, Satan's been holding on to my stuff.
Yes.
God said, just call on that name.
Yes.
Because when he trembles, yes, he's going to have to let go of everything he's been holding on. Do I have any believers in here?
Yes, sir.
I just need about 20 of y'all to get ready. We're going to call him until he comes in this place. Any real saints in here that know there's still power in the name of Jesus? Anybody believe that the blood still works? Huh? I count to three, begin to call him. Call him until you see your house getting better. Hey, 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 hey. Call him until you see your money get better.